everyone. Movies, Hollywood, Oscar Award. These are words that excite a lot of people. And I found myself under limelight about 5 years ago when I was part of a team that received the Academy Award for Scientific and Technical Excellence for our work on a tool used by artists at Sony Pictures Imageworks. After decades of working behind the scenes like so many other technicians in our industry, I received my 15 seconds of fame and I found myself standing on that stage on the Academy, thanking co-workers, family, friends and all the wonderful people who were instrumental to me being on that stage. It was a proud moment, not only for me and my family and friends, but also to so many other people who saw it as the proof that someone like them can get a glamorous recognition like that. Either by profession or by the language I spoke at home or by the country that I was born or by the school or college I went to, each saw something that they can relate to and found inspiration that someone like themselves was able to get that kind of public attention. Thanks to the brand name of Hollywood and Oscar, there was a lot of media attention from India to know more about my background in the weeks and months that followed that award. Naturally, people were curious to know more about my story. I grew up in a small village near a city called Coimbatore, located in southern India. When it was revealed that I grew up in a rural environment, went to a government school and studied in my own mother tongue Tamil until college, it seemed to surprise a lot of people. That surprise is not unwarranted, and it's a common knowledge that in order to be successful, high quality education is a must, and this high quality education is only available in cities and often taught in English in private schools where the tuition fees alone will make sure only children of middle class and above would have access to such an environment. This disparity between the educational opportunities available for underprivileged children in rural areas versus those of living in urban areas for wealthier parents is a global issue, not just unique to India or even other developing countries. Worldwide, poor children in rural areas being taught in government schools in native languages face huge barriers to success, even for getting into decent colleges and universities where they can get the quality higher education necessary for getting a good job and getting out of the cycle of poverty. Let's take India as an example and take a closer look at the data. In India, currently about 2/3 of the population is living in rural areas. Free and compulsory education is provided to children from the age of 6 through 14 by constitutional right. In many states, free meals are served in government schools. According to some studies, about 96% of all children go to school in India, which is great. About 70% of students go to publicly funded government schools and the rest go to private schools. These private schools are often only found in cities. For the most part, public education is taught in one of India's regional languages. On the other hand, it's common for private education to be taught in English, which is valued for employability not only within India but across the world. Because of this and other reasons based on the quality of education, even really poor people decide to send their kids to private schools, though public schools are completely free. Now let's take the vast majority of the student population. They are from rural environments, from households, and their parents are typically not literate and only speak their regional language at home. What's the quality of education they receive? What kind of opportunities are available to these children and how much actual learning takes place in these schools? According to a recent government report, the number of students going to school in rural India is increasing. However, more than 50% of the students in the 5th standard are not capable of reading a textbook of 2nd standard. They don't know how to solve even basic mathematical problems. According to one study, 40% of 18-year-olds cannot do basic math, like taking 10% of a number or understand a simple English sentence like, what is time? How can the student succeed in getting into college where the primary medium of instruction is often English, or get into a job where basic language and analytical skills are a must? What are the main problems? Poor infrastructure is a big issue. Even basic things like toilets may not be available, and there is a lack of teachers, as well as a lot of absenteeism with available teachers. Training for teachers is not great. About 90% of government schools struggle to match at least one teacher per each grade. Parents intuitively know this, and they are desperate for better quality of education. They pay whatever they can to send their children to private schools, even in rural areas. High quality education is often available in cities that rivals or even exceed international standards, but rural children remain out of reach. But on average, the private schools found in rural areas are often not that different from poorly performing government schools. What can we do to bridge the gap between the educational opportunities available for rural children compared to those in urban areas? Obviously, more funding and attention from the government will help, but how realistic is it for developing countries? My background is technology, and as we all know, when used correctly, technology has been a great enabler of power to ordinary, everyday people. It is getting cheaper, and things like internet and the mobile phones have made their way into even the most remote places on earth. Once you get access to technology and access to the internet, the whole world opens up for those who know where to find them and how to use them. I believe we need two things to make this happen. One is make the information accessible to everyone. Number two, spread the awareness and train the teachers and students on how to access it. To make the information available, this often means translating the content from English to native languages. For example, I am proud to be associated with a nonprofit which is involved in translating a very popular website that provides online tools for students and educators for self-learning. With these kind of tools, a properly trained teacher can train a lot of students to help themselves. This will, of course, never substitute the quality of teaching by a human making that personal connection, but it's a whole lot better than empty classrooms. There are highly motivated and enterprising kids everywhere, and if these tools reach their hands, then they will take it from there. Making them available in native language is very important. Several neurological studies have stressed the importance of learning in the same language the kids speak at home. Once they master the primary concepts and get fluency in English, then transitioning into a primarily English language learning environment for higher grades or college is a lot more seamless. This was my case, and I believe it was an important factor to my own professional success. Yes. I grew up in a rural environment and went to government school and studied in my own native language. But if you look closely, my own father was the headmaster of the school, and my mother was also a teacher in the same school who was the first person to teach me English. I was also extremely lucky to have wonderful teachers pretty much throughout my school as well as college who nurtured a love for learning and a passion for science and technology. Yes, with sufficient drive and self-motivation, there are countless number of kids that have come from even the remotest corners of the earth and go on to succeed, but those are outliers and often have similar advantages like that of my own. Let's use technology to level that playing field. The digital divide is a real thing, and it's accelerating and leaving our rural kids in the dust. But we don't have to leave it that way. Let's apply our human ingenuity to come up with innovative solutions to find and nurture talent from anywhere on the earth, no matter where they live or depend on the luck. Thank you for listening.